New tonight at 10, she spent years helping others. Now the table is turned, how area students are supporting their teacher through a dark time.
I miss her dearly. It's really hard without her, but she'll be back.
Well, good evening. Thanks for being with us. I'm Eric Franke.
And I'm Michelle Lee. A Madison teacher is getting the support of her entire school as she battles cancer. News 3's Keely Arthur shows us the big event students put on to raise her spirits.
Ever since she was a little girl, that's what she wanted to do.
Teacher Jodi Steidel has dedicated the last 20 years to staff and students at Hamilton Middle School.
She's just a loving person. She just is able to make connections with all kinds of kids.
If they're struggling, she'll try to find a way to individually help them.
But the eighth grade English teacher who has touched the lives of thousands of kids is now fighting for her own life.
In the springtime, she was diagnosed with MDS, which is a blood disease. And then after about a month, we found out it had turned into a leukemia.
She immediately began aggressive chemotherapy and received a bone marrow transplant last month.
She actually just this week was able to be released from the hospital and continue her recovery at home.
While doctors say her health is improving, she was also told some bad news.
She has taken a year off from teaching because of being around kids and colds and stuff. She easily catches things.
To show their support for a teacher who has supported them for so long, students and staff organized a walk in her honor.
I think she is just overwhelmed with joy and emotion.
While she wasn't able to witness the hundreds who came out on Friday,
thank you for coming and supporting my mom.
Everyone says they will give her just as big of a greeting when she returns to Hamilton.
I miss her dearly. It's really hard without her, but she'll be back. So.
Students and staff raised money for leukemia research by selling the t-shirts you saw at the walk. Steidel's family also wanted to use this as an opportunity to remind everyone to donate blood.
Yeah, a lot of people in support of her. Very good story. Yeah, thank you, Keely.
Welcome back. It is 6:44 right now on a beautiful Friday morning. You're looking down State Street there live on this Friday morning. It's going to be a beautiful day out today. Try and get outside if you can. So we like to talk around here about doing something good for others, and that's what one local middle school is doing today, because a teacher at Madison's Hamilton School was recently diagnosed with leukemia. She's starting chemotherapy soon, so today her school community is showing its support in a special way. With us this morning is 8th grade language arts teacher Meredith Raymer. Thanks so much for being with us, Meredith.
Thanks for having me.
So tell us a little bit about your friend, your colleague, Jodi, who has leukemia.
And actually, she's in remission from leukemia and is recently recovering from her bone marrow transplant, which she had on September 14th. Her brother was a complete match for that. So she is now, actually just this week, received word from her doctors exactly 5 months to the day on Tuesday that from her original diagnosis that she would be able to go home and recover. So she's at home.
That's awesome.
Yes,
I imagine a lot of students at Hamilton, a lot of your colleagues probably had, you know, you hear the word leukemia, you get really scared, you don't really know a lot about it.
Right.
How has this over the last few months kind of come together to lead to today?
It actually started this summer. I was sitting around a pool with some colleagues, and our physical education teachers said, would this be something that you think Jodi would enjoy and would be good for our community, our school community? And I said, absolutely. So began the process of ordering these wonderful t-shirts. And starting at the beginning of the school year, we set out orders for the t-shirts and allowed students and staff and families to donate to the Leukemia Lymphoma Society. Mm-hmm. And so here we are.
You know, teachers to so many of us are superheroes, and if we can't help you make $1 million, maybe we can at least help kind of raise the awareness of what Jodi herself wanted to talk about.
Yes.
As it relates to this, which
yes.
is...
I just spoke with her on the phone yesterday, and she and her husband, Tom, were talking about the dire need for blood donations. She alone, the amount of transfusions that she had during her clinical visits and her hospital stay were pretty great. So, I mean, she just left the hospital with one. So if people can get out to their local blood banks, visit their American Red Cross and donate blood or platelets, that would absolutely help our people suffering from blood disorders.
You know, Meredith, I would imagine just kind of being together will help this community
absolutely.
As well. I mean, how you know, it helps you deal with the fear.
Absolutely. This is a really emotional day for our school community. Jodi is a beloved teacher. We miss her dearly. And today we get to honor her by walking the mile perimeter around the building. Some students and staff will run it, And Madison Water Utility has come out to bring water for our kids, and we will gather and celebrate this wonderful woman. So,
thank you. And
thank
it's
you.
Jodi Steidel. I didn't even mention
Jodi
her
Steidel.
Last name.
Yes.
Thanks for all you're doing.
Thank you so much.
We wish her the best and wish her family the best as well. Now, it is a private walk, right?
I mean, it is a private walk, yes.
Okay.
Like you said, we have nearly 1,000 right. people walking this very tight perimeter, and actually we're under construction because we're adding onto our building. So, yeah, but if people can donate in the way of leukemia, lymphoma, or get out and get to the blood banks, that would be wonderful.
Maybe we can help with at least that former part. If you want to help out, there is an upcoming fundraiser that you can take part in benefiting the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society of Wisconsin. The Light the Night Walk is next Thursday here in Madison. Starts at 4:30 at the Duck Pond in Warner Park. For more information, you can go to lls.org/Wisconsin. Meredith, good luck. Thank you again.
Thank
Please
you.
Tell Jodi we wish her the best.
We'll do. Thank you.
Magic 98 with Hamilton Middle School doing a fun run walk today for one of their beloved teachers, Miss Steidel, an eighth grade English teacher who's battling leukemia. If this touches home for you and you'd like to help, go ahead. You can make a donation to the Leukemia Lymphoma Association. And I'm told by Ms. Raymer, another eighth grade English teacher, that this is a huge song for them. So as they run walk, this is the song they'll be thinking of. Rachel Platten, Fight Song, Magic 98.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. My power's turned on.
Starting right now.
I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In too deep. I say I'm in too deep.
In too deep.
And it's been 2 years. I miss my home. But there's a fire burning in my bones. Still believe. Yeah, I still believe. And all those things I didn't say. Wrecking balls inside my brain. I was screaming.
No, I've still got a lot of fight left in me.